Airlock Houston, you're looking good. We're 20 seconds out. Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston, this is the International Space Station. I'm ready for the event.
MSNBC, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
Station, this is Kendis Gibson with MSNBC. How do you hear me?
Kendis, this is Victor Glover aboard the International Space Station. Welcome. I have you loud and clear.
That is awesome. Victor, it's so great to see you again. Not sure if you recall, we did a trip on a Viking cruise a little while ago. The Foistool sends their hello. Take me through that moment, Victor, when you crossed over. I could see your smile from ear to ear. You were hugging everybody. Take me through that moment right there.
Yes, it is great to talk to you again, and I remember that cruise. It was an amazing experience, and it's great to talk to you now in this context. I would say the biggest thing, amidst all those amazing moments that were happening, flying a Crew Dragon, a new spacecraft to the International Space Station, arriving to the space station safely, the two biggest things that were going through my mind were I was very happy to see those familiar faces on the other side in Kate, Sergey, and I was also very happy that they had a camera there rolling because I knew my family would see me and that they would be able to exhale and just say, all right, this part's done. One phase of the mission is over, and we can breathe easy for now. And so that made me very happy.
What about the history of it all? Yes, you are the 14th black American astronaut, to make it there in space. But that's out of 300. You know, when we had mathematicians that were black way back in the days. Take me through the history of your moment.
You know, Kendis, it is a great question because it's nuanced, but I'll try to keep it short. It's bittersweet. I think back to all of the folks who could have done this before me, and there are many. All of those 14 plus several others, and there are folks that will come behind me that will continue this amazing legacy. And so I just think about them anytime somebody brings this up. But also. I think we should celebrate. It's important that little kids can look out and see someone who looks like them and that they can put into the context of their upbringing that they can achieve what they set out to achieve, that they can dream big and accomplish those things. But most important is the idea that this is the beginning of this becoming normal. This is the beginning of us not having to celebrate this because in the future, it's going to just continue to happen. Like I said, there are some very talented people behind me that are going to do this. And I look forward to celebrating that when it just becomes regular.
Absolutely. And I'm so happy for you. All of that said, you're going to the moon.
That's a pretty wild thought, isn't it? It's a pretty wild thought. It's amazing that you know I can be up here and that news comes out and I'm honored to be a part of the Artemis team. And you know we haven't made the crew assignments yet. Once we make the actual crew assignments on who's going on what missions to the moon, then we can celebrate those folks. And whether I'm on a crew or not, if I'm in a spacecraft that's go for translunar injection headed 240,000 miles to the moon, I'll be excited. But I would be just as excited to sit in mission control and support them from the ground. And so whatever my role in this journey is, I'm looking forward to supporting in any way I can.
Well, that is absolutely amazing. But take me through, Victor, I watched several hours of your 8-hour spacewalk. Take me through that moment when you first stepped out there, or if glided out there, as I would say, and you said, this is absolutely beautiful.
You know, it's interesting that you ask about that very first moment. I got a lot of advice from colleagues, friends, family even. Lots of prayers and thoughts came up, and that's one of the things I love about this mission. But one of my colleagues, Anne McLean, gave me some really great advice. She said, keep your world small. And I know someone told her that, and it was probably passed down through several generations of astronauts and cosmonauts. And that was the one thing that I was focusing on, was just focusing on what is right in front of me in the task and talking and my teammate, Mike Hopkins, and my teammates on the ground. Because I didn't want to be overwhelmed by the awesomeness of everything else going on. And so I slowly widened that world out and expanded it as I had the capacity. But first, going out of the hatch, it can be pretty overwhelming. And so I knew it was going to be overwhelming, and I just tried to keep one thing at a time on my mind so that I could make sure to not mess that thing up.
And that one thing was the task at hand, I assume, was the case. So, Victor, while you've been up there, I know that you had an inaugural address, but you also witnessed history, not the political aspect, just from one person who is black making history up in space and noticing this on the ground with the first female vice president.
You know, again, I think it is a great thing for us to celebrate now. It is a moment, and we should enjoy that moment. But I also think that it's important, as with any accomplishment, you know, it's one of the reasons I use sports so much. Whether you win or lose a game, Monday, you go back to practice. And so I think it's important for us to enjoy this moment, but I think it's also important for us to recognize we still have a lot of work to do, and this is the beginning. This work that we're doing right now is the beginning of these things becoming normal. And so my hat's off to Vice President Kamala Harris and to her family on this amazing accomplishment, but also my hat's off to the country on continuing to have a peaceful transition of power and for us to continue to move forward and be the beacon of light, the light on a hill for the rest of the world.
Yes, and I noticed that was part of the inaugural message that you guys had, and it was great to hear from you guys at that moment. Let's talk about a little bit of sports, because Kobe Bryant was very proud about being a girl dad. And you have a lot of practice in being a girl dad. What sort of advice did those young ladies give you as you got up there, and what's it like to be a girl dad who's an astronaut?
You know, I have learned more from being a girl dad and being a dad, period, than I have it being a naval officer or an astronaut. It has really taught me a lot about not just them, my four daughters, but also about myself, and really just taking the time to understand and get to know them as individuals. One of the things I truly miss being up here is taking them out individually and just spending time talking to them about what's on their minds, and also helping them with their homework. I really love helping them with their homework. But you know, being a girl dad, it is a special thing. I think Kobe and a lot of my friends, we do have a special bond that we share being girl dads. It is very unique, and I am constantly learning and always open for tips.
Well, I don't have any tips at all to give you. But two quick questions. What's been the coolest part about this experience? Something that you did not even expect during all that training that you did?
That is a good question in terms of the unexpected nature. I mean, I knew that I was going to love the view, and I do. I could go sit in the cupola, and one of my goals is to sit in the cupola for a full orbit for 90 minutes and go all the way around the Earth. I haven't done it yet. I've done it almost. I've been there for about an hour, but I need 90 minutes. But as far as something that I didn't know, I think I'm most amazed. I truly am most amazed by the reaction of friends and family to this experience. I've been in this job for 7 years, but this part of it, launching and getting here and being on orbit and sharing these experiences with them, I try very much to share through the pictures and videos and send them short notes about the things that we're thinking about and going through up here. And the amount of interest and response that I get back really says that, hey, folks are hungry for what we're doing up here and they want to know more. And that is very encouraging. And that, the thoughtfulness, the concern, the support that we get from the ground is the thing that actually surprises me the most.
And I love love that you can spin around the world in 90 minutes. That's amazing. Really quickly, I'm not sure if you remember what I looked like, but we got confused for each other quite a bit on the cruise. How does one maintain the dome in space? It's rough enough here on Earth.
Well, let me tell you, it is not easy because shaving, you know, microgravity, Kate said it yesterday. We were talking to the director of the National Science Foundation, and some of the things that make microgravity awesome also make it challenging. So shaving your head up here, you have to really be on the lookout for loose particles because the gel wants to go away and it floats off in every direction if you're not careful. So one, a rule that we have in aviation and in space flight, slow is smooth and smooth is fast. So that's one. But two, shaving with a disposable razor adds a whole nother dimension to it as well. At home, I get a few more resources that I don't have up here. And so, again, slow is smooth and smooth is fast so that I don't cut myself and have to walk around with, dots of toilet paper on my head. But it is a challenge, but we make it work.
Their worst things, and that's a great motto for life. Victor, congratulations. So proud to see you and happy to see you. I remember talking briefly on that cruise and you talking about you are going to be one of the astronauts in space. So it's wonderful to see it.
It is so great to talk to you as well. I hope you're doing well down there. Stay safe, and it's been great talking to you from the International Space Station.
Thank you. Thank you. Be well, brother. Good to see you. Thank you, guys.
Station, this is Houston ACR. That concludes the event. Thank you.
Thank you to all the participants from MSNBC. Station, please stand by while we reconfigure video and audio communications.